From the best in most country, Big Frog O 104, Luke Bryan, and that's my kind of night. It is 8:10, a good morning, and we have a slew. I could make a band in here this morning with the amount of people that we have. Mom, you may need to get that mic if you want to talk so it's closer. So can I have a hello, Mom, just to make sure it's working?
Hello.
And introduce yourself.
Bobby Spencer.
And we've got 6, if I can count correctly. Well, 5 kids and another mom.
Yes.
So, kids, can you introduce yourselves? These are all students from Stockbridge I almost said elementary. You guys are not elementary kids. Stockbridge High School, correct?
Yes.
All right. Can you all introduce yourselves?
I'm Haley Smith.
I'm Abby Tucker.
I'm Sierra Tucci.
I'm Grace Jason.
I'm Jonathan Mound.
Well, hello, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Why aren't you in school today?
We're all suspended.
Suspended? What were you doing? Were you throwing rocks at cars, or what was going on, you guys?
No, we were sitting out in front of the tunnels.
Doing peaceful protest.
Yeah.
So what were you protesting?
Against bullying in our school.
Bullying and discrimination in Stockbridge Valley.
So, I mean, were you yelling, screaming? I don't understand.
We're silent.
Nope. For the majority of the time, we actually sat there with duct tape over our mouths, and we were told to take it off because they thought we were trying to self-harm ourselves. So we took that off following their request, and we sat out there completely silent and managed to get suspended.
So, and Mom, what were the reasons? Because you got a note there. They were suspended for reasonings. You were given reasons why they were suspended.
Yes, they were suspended for insubordination, failures to comply with a reasonable request, and truancy.
Now, weren't you guys asked to stop and come into school?
Yes.
Yeah, we were.
And you decided not to?
We told them we were going to wait for our parents to get there because that was our instructions from our parents. And they said, you can come in and talk to us now. There is no later. So we waited for our parents to get there, and Nicole went inside, Bobby went inside, and another parent went inside, and they didn't even speak to these two. They spoke to one parent and basically told everybody else that we had to leave.
So you guys go back to school tomorrow, is that right?
Right.
And Mom, are you supposed to meet with the school?
Yes, we're all meeting today.
To meet with the school to...
Yes, to re-entry for all the kids. Each parent has to have their kid come in and have a re-entry conference with the principal and superintendent.
So your kids have been suspended from school for standing up for bullying inside schools. And you were telling me yesterday, Bobby, that some of you guys aren't being bullied. You're just standing up for others. Is that right?
Right.
Yeah.
So do you support their decision even though they've been suspended from school, Mom?
I do. I think that this is a epidemic. It's everywhere. It's not going anywhere. It's going to be around for a while. And they're just trying to make something positive and a change. They have a friend who is 12 years old who has been bullied by students and staff at the school. And He's 12 years old, and he's an emotional wreck. Half the time doesn't want to go to school because he has to deal with something there, and it's very awful to watch.
So you guys have decided to take these lemons and make lemonade. First, I noticed that you started a new Facebook page. Can someone tell me a little bit about that and what your goals are for that?
The Facebook page is called Bully Away. We all have access to it. It's mainly used for any kid, student, parents, whoever feels like they just need a place to get away, they just need to talk, they can message us. We've had people from Rome, we've had people from Morrisville, we've had people from as far as Ohio message us and ask us for the bracelets. So we're mailing bracelets out like crazy. We're receiving messages from people that need help in school, our school, other schools. There's people that just plain out need to talk.
And what's the purpose of the bracelets?
Well, the purple stands for, like, the protesting against bullying. Not necessarily the protesting, but for the awareness of harassment. Yeah.
And then, in addition to all of this, you guys are going to hold monthly meetings, I'm told?
Yeah.
Yep. Right at the town building.
Yeah. We discussed it last night, and because of the outreach of so many people, we planned on having a monthly meeting, or even if it gets bigger, weekly, and going to other areas so that people can meet with us in Syracuse if they want, or Utica, and we'll meet with them.
So, kids, what's your overall goal? What are you hoping to accomplish? I know you've made the statement out on the street, but now we're going bigger.
I really just want people to realize that no matter what happens, no matter what position you're in, I've been at the factory, you feel alone. And we're here for everybody. Like you said earlier, I'm not necessarily one that gets shoved around. I'm not bullied by students at school. But it just comes to the point sometimes where you have to give other people a backbone and you have to give other people the chance to speak. Not everybody will listen to you, especially the administration at Stockbridge Valley. We've tried, we've said our words, it's brushed under the carpet. So we're here not only for ourselves, but for everybody else around us in the community.
Okay, so by a show of hands, we got five kids. How many out of you five have been bullied at school? Wow. 4 out of 5? Seriously?
By administration is more of what we're going through rather than the students.
Absolutely.
Which is,
he's been
sickening.
Students.
Bad.
So the hospital visits.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm.
Well, good for you for standing up for not only yourself, but for everyone else. Now, again, this information on the website, because I'm sure a lot of people are going to want to reach out and help, because there sometimes is no help. So just one hand is all the difference it could make.
And that's what we want to make sure that they know, is that our Facebook page, it gets sent to all of us, and someone will always be there to answer.
Well, but what if I don't want my words, like, out in public, though?
You can message private it. Message. It's private messaging.
Oh, it's all private in a secret group,
yep,
so it's not write. Like it's
yeah.
on...
You can,
you've got the
you
basic
can post,
group.
You can post on the page,
but then you can private
choice,
message.
But you can also private message,
yep,
which
yep.
we will all get the notification. So even if there's, like, a certain individual you'd like to talk to, you know, just say, hey, can I have a minute with Bobby? Can I have a minute with Haley? Whatever you are most comfortable with. Is what we're trying to get to you.
At any time.
Yeah.
Or just some kid that doesn't know anyone and just says, I want to talk to someone.
Yeah,
yes.
Last
exactly.
night.
Yep.
And I was talking to her up until 11:30
yep.
last night.
So, and this just started yesterday.
Yeah, right.
The
yeah.
Facebook page just got
yeah,
up
I put
and
it
running
up
yesterday.
Yeah, I think I was the first member, and like 5 minutes later, there was 20 members. So.
Yeah.
So search on Facebook for Bully Away and more information on those monthly meetings, because sometimes a face-to-face makes all the difference,
yeah, absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely. And there's a toolkit that I have ordered from PACER.org, which is the National Organization Against Bullying and Children with Disabilities. I ordered a toolkit, and at our meetings we'll have, like, bookmarks and pamphlets and information. And on the bookmarks we'll have our Facebook page and information on how to get a hold of us. And it's an honor, because PACER.org doesn't have anyone in Central New York that is a contact.
And now they do. All
and
because
now they do.
All because you guys got suspended.
Yeah.
So enjoy your last day off.
They've been
productive, it sounds like, for the days off, right?
Yeah, they have been very productive, and they have
proud of them.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming in, sharing your story. How old is everyone?
They're very safe.
I'm 17. I'm the oldest.
15.
Me and her are going to be 15.
Going to be 15.
Yeah. I'm 15.
And 15, too. Your parents, take a bow. You should be very proud for not only standing up for yourself, but standing up for everyone else, and for making lemonade out of those lemons. Thank you very much for coming in. We appreciate it. 819, Big Frog 104.